what our life should be like, how our story should have gone, or should go in the future, what I should be doing today, but I'm not. I should be more like Pastor Emmett, but I'm not. All the shoulds that run through our minds and that run through the world of even people and systems and TV telling us who we should be.
And she gave birth to her firstborn.
story may or may not be believed. And there's always a shame when you have the courage to tell your truth and people are praising you for telling your truth. There's still that shame of, should I keep this to myself? Is there something wrong with me that this is even part of my story? And so Mary's in this awkward position of, well, no one's really going to believe her. It says in the scriptures that Joseph decided to stay with Mary, and because of the angel coming in and saying, hey, don't abandon this woman. My plan is for you to help make sure this baby gets born by not allowing her to get stoned to death.
Yeah.
You got to play a role, right? And Joseph steps up. He plays that role, and he says, all right, I'm going to take her in as my wife. Again, one of these sentimental images be the victims of brutality from the government, and he was the only one that survived. I think he had to grapple with that. He had to grapple what it means to be a survivor. His parents were also great at improvising. I mean, these stories of like, now then your mom was pregnant with you, and we didn't know what to do, so we came up with this plan to go have you in Bethlehem. And then, oh no, we heard that Herod was trying to kill you, so then we, you know, hooked down to Egypt for a while. We didn't know how long we were going to be there, and then the angel told us it was safe to go back. You can imagine the misadventures that they had along the way, how they had to improvise economically because they weren't in their hometown. They didn't have the whose faith